cookies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzel with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into springs. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I
welcome back to my channel. Today we're serving a little Alice in Wonderland, a little Julie Andrews up in the mountains with the little children vibes. I'm loving it. Absolutely gorgeous. So today what we're going to be doing is, during quarantine, we're going to be using some objects that you can find around your house or when you go out for your, you know, essential weekly shop, pick them up. We're going to be making some tomato bread, two loaves, and we'll be making some chocolate fudge, sea salt dark chocolate fudge, simple three ingredients, and then we'll also be making another simple three ingredient recipe, the Delgona, don't know how you say it, coffee, the whipped coffee. So I've got a lot to go on today, a lot to come, so stay tuned. Hit like, hit subscribe, share with your friends, share with your mum, dad, nan, everyone, all of that good shit, and yeah, let's get into it. Hi, so we're going to start today with the tomato bread. Now, just quickly wanted to let you guys know, I do have some help off camera today. I have my sister here, Kim. So she's going to be helping out to get all of these wonderful home recipes achieved. But she doesn't want to come on camera, which is fair enough. So what you're going to first of all need is your big bowl. I'm just going to push some of the other things off to the side for the moment. And you're going to start with the bread. So get your bowl. You will need 5 cups of flour, and it's 3 all-purpose, 2 self-raising, 2 tablespoons of yeast, or that's equivalent to 2 7-gram packets. Then we're going to need 2 teaspoons of sugar, 1 teaspoon of salt, 2 cups of warm water, and a 1/4 cup of cooking oil, 4 tablespoons of tomato puree. So first of all, we're going to put 4 cups of the flour, yeast, sugar, and salt into a large bowl. So here we go. Get your measuring apparatus. And here we have 1 cup. So we're going to start with the plain flour. This bag is going to be very poorly by myself when I was making pizzas. Now I do have, actually, I bought a new hand whisk yesterday. And it comes with bread dough attachments, which is great. It means that we don't have to do as much of the work. Now, obviously, you will still need to knead it by hand at the end just to make sure it's where you want it to be. But that's the whole fun of making bread at home. So there goes 1 cup. Now, this does yield 2 loaves of bread. So if you want to half the recipe, half the recipe. If you want to double it, double it. Make it work for you, baby girl. I'm making a loaf for my friend's family, so I'm making a mess as well, apparently. There goes 2 cups of the plain flour. Then I'm going to do the third one, 1 cup of the self-raising, save the other cup for self-raising for later on.
You cut this bit out.
That'll be right up. Now, the first thing for kitchen is a mise en place, which in French, I believe, means clean as you go. It's something I've never really been good at, but we're going to give it a go today. Amazing. Now, I like to mix self-raising, even though I'm using yeast, because it just gives you that lighter, fluffy, really lifted dough, which I think, you know, everyone really likes. So there we go. Put that into there. 2 tablespoons of yeast. 2 teaspoons of sugar and 1 teaspoon of salt. Brilliant. Kim's going to read off how much I should be adding. So of the yeast.
2 tablespoons.
2 tablespoons. Yes, love. Here we go. 1. That's 2 tablespoons of yeast.
2 tablespoons of sugar.
And we are going to be using brown sugar because I think it's a nicer taste. So there's 1. And now this sugar is going to be a food for the yeast. That they will eat it and then bubble away and get all nice and bubbly. So here we go. Salt. Bombs away. 2 cups of hot water. So for that, we're going to boil the kettle. So I'll be back once that's done. Okay, my lovelies. So now that the kettle's boiled, I'm going to add 1 cup hot water, 1 cup cold water to make warm water. So let's go ahead. I've got a little measuring jug here of cold water. I'm just going to fill up my 1 cup measurement to make sure that we're getting it right. Usually with recipes, I'm a little bit, you know, whatever you want. But with baking, it is good to be precise. So there goes 1 cup cold. I'm just going to give this off to my assistant. Thank you, darling. And now 1 cup hot. Please be careful not to burn yourselves. And there we go. Brilliant. And I will give this to my assistant. Round of applause for Kimberly. Now we're going to go ahead and take our wooden spatula and begin to mix this in. Almost forgot the oil. That would have been silly, wouldn't it? So this is 1/4 cup of vegetable oil. Sorry, my love. Carry on reading the instructions.
Okay. Pour in hot water and oil and mix until combined. It will be sticky.
Awesome.
Add the remaining
sticky
flour in until dough is no longer sticky.
It's going to be so sticky.
You knead for about 5 minutes until the dough is elastic.
You've been a bad boy. And your bread's going to be sticky. Now the recipe I'm using is just a normal bread recipe that I am adapting into a tomato bread recipe. So what I'm going to do is, whilst it's still sticking, I'm going to add a little bit of black pepper, just ground straight in. And I'm just doing this to taste, just to how I like it. So I'll do that for the moment, mix it in and see how much. You don't want it to overtake the loaf, obviously, but I would like to be able to see some little speckled bits in there, you know, little pepper, if you will. Now that that's all mixed in and nice and sticky, we're going to go ahead and add the other cup of flour as instructed. Now, I'm using self-raising flour for this part, so I'm going to go ahead and weigh off a cup and pour it in. So, now that that's all been added, let's stir until it's no longer sticky. So now that we've got this all nice and mixed in, I can see it's starting to come together and it's not sticky anymore. What I'm going to do is, because I'm lazy and I just bought it, I really, really want to test it out. I'm going to go ahead and get out my new hand mixer. Now, I did use it yesterday when we were having a practice of the coffee I'm going to be showing you guys later. And it's delicious, I'll tell you that for nothing. But it comes with bread kneading attachments, which I think is absolutely wonderful. So let's get this bad boy out. We have the Silvercrest kitchen tools. So there's going to be so much fake hair in all this food. And it's a lovely, lovely colour. Just so happens to match my outfit, funnily enough. So let's take out these are the whisk attachments. We'll be using those later on. We want these little bread hooks. Arr. Arr. Oh, would you look at that? It's like a perfect colour. It's like a panda. Now make sure we get these on the right ones, love. This one in here. This one in here. So now I'm going to put in 4 tablespoons of tomato puree. 1, 2, 3, 4. Absolutely gorgeous, stunning, magnificent, delicious. Now if you have any other herbs and seasonings you want to add, please add it at this stage. You know, you can really make this what you want. Garlic, herbs, you could add basil, oregano. It's really, really up to you. That's the beauty of baking at home, is you can customize it to your exact taste. Now I usually would love a bit of garlic and oregano, basil, all of that in there, but my mum's a bit of a moody bitch, so I'm gonna stick with just the tomato bread, which I think was even a push for her. So let's put this dirty spatula bad boy off to the side, and let's get these going. So we're gonna start on low speed, slowly work my way up. I'm going to speed this clip up so you won't have to actually hear me whizzing it, but here we go. Okay guys, it's kneading by hand time. Now my dough still looks a little sticky and I've actually gone through all my flour because I was baking pizzas the other day. Oh, tickle on the nose. Jesus. So I might have to run to the shop quickly to get some flour. I'm hoping not. But what I'm gonna do in the meantime is empty the dough out onto the side. Some of this flour I just added, I haven't mixed in properly yet, but I wanted to get it onto the side, start to work it with my hands, because you can't really know a dough until you've felt it. I mean, do you know anyone until you've felt them? That's the question. Oh, it's actually feeling all right.
It's pretty good, yeah.
Oh, it feels so soft. So I'm just kneading, it's a push, fold, push, fold. Now because of that extra water from the tomato paste, it's gonna be a slightly stickier dough anyway. That's what I'm going with. So I'm gonna place that back into my bowl and cover with a damp, clean tea towel, leave to rise for approximately 30 minutes. It should double in size. So I'm just gonna pop that off to the side. Whilst we're waiting for that, let's get started on the next one. Okay, darlings, so we've got the bread setting off in the back there. I've just done a little clean up of my area, put all the ingredients I'm not gonna need away, did a little wash up of what I am gonna need to reuse, and we're moving on to the three ingredient chocolate fudge, sing song, dark. Knife, chopping board, 3 bars of dark chocolate. Now you want two, it needs to be 300 grams, that's 3 bars usually. You want two that are around 50%, 50, 60%, and then one that's a little bit higher, 74%. So we've got a little bit of a mix. You don't want too much. I mean, obviously to personal preference, but I'm making it for a family that don't really love dark chocolate. I would go, you know, 3 bars of 74%, but they like a little bit of sweet. Now, once you add it to the sweetened condensed milk, it's got the richness of dark chocolate, but almost like a milk chocolate, but it's still very much dark chocolate. Like, you can tell what it is. So I'm gonna go ahead and chop the first bar, and this doesn't need to be perfect, as you can see. This needs to be chopped. So now that you've done your best to add all the chocolate and not get any on the side, we're just gonna do a quick angle change so you can see how we're gonna be melting the chocolate over on the cooker. So I'll see you over there. So we've got the kettle boiled, our chocolate chopped, we've got our sea salt for in a little bit, and we've got our sweetened condensed milk. Okay guys, we've got the water on bubbling and we've got our trays lined. Now we attempted to make this yesterday, it didn't go quite as planned. I'm not gonna show you because we're gonna do it well today. And it actually ended up filling this one, but we're putting in a little bit more chocolate today. That was the problem, it didn't quite set. So I'm hoping it's gonna fit, but we might have to use the big ones. We've gone ahead and lined both just in case. We're gonna pop this in here, just hook that nicely in there. That way it doesn't move out the way. Grab my wooden spatula, which has been cleaned since making the bread, and I'm gonna turn the heat all the way down. You don't want to burn the chocolate, dark chocolate, especially, can sometimes go quite bitter because it is already quite bitter as it is. So we're just going to gently stir this. So do not put your handle resting on your pot because it's going to melt. We just avoided disaster very narrowly. Ah, fuck! So with our chocolate all the way melted and disaster averted, I've got my sweetened condensed milk open, the can's fallen in, so I'm just going to pour it all over my finger and right into the pan. Brilliant. Mm. That'll probably end up in Pornhub. So the recipe calls for 400 grams of sweetened condensed milk for 300 grams of chocolate. Give this to my lovely assistant Kimberly. And now we're going to, with it on the lowest heat, add in all of your chocolate. I'll stand here, see. She doesn't want to be on camera. She's going to be behind me staring. I'm going to do a little close-up. Me scraping out the chocolate from this bowl. Mm, this jug. The measuring jug. Look at these jugs. Oh, it looks delicious already. Absolutely delightful. And then you just sort of give it a quick mix. Make sure it's all fully incorporated and as smooth as possible. And I'm going to go ahead and show you what it should look like, hopefully. Nice, thick, creamy, delicious. So you can remove that from the heat. And I'm just going to let that, just while I've stirred, to cool it down. Don't let it sit because it might start to set before your very eyes. It probably won't, but it's good to keep an eye on it at all times. I like to just sort of stir, aerate it, and this helps the chocolate and the condensed milk to cool down enough, just so we can pour it. So now with your carefully lined dish, now remember you can use tin foil, parchment paper, cling film, you're going to take your thick chocolate fudge and just pour it right in. Look at that silky, creamy nutmeg ganache. So here we are, the chocolate fudge. We're going to leave it to set just for a little while before adding the sea salt. I'm going to go wash my hands and then we'll be back to make the thick Delgona coffee. Welcome back. I've just done a little lip gloss and top up while I was waiting for the kettle to boil. Now we're going to be starting on the coffee. We'll be going back to do the sea salt on the chocolate, putting that into the fridge to set. I've just had a quick check on the dough. It's risen massively. We do need to pop to the shop and get a few things just before I put it in the oven and let it rise a little bit more. So I'll show you that, guys, as well later on. But for the moment, let's get into what I'm really, really excited for and has become my new favourite obsession. This whipped, creamy coffee concoction. I love it. I'm about it. Let's get into it. So it's really, really simple. You can whisk it by hand. It takes about 10 minutes. With a machine, it takes about 2 or 3. So I do definitely prefer using the machine. When I used my hand whisk, it actually snapped all the spindles off and I had to throw it away. Now I'm making quite a large quantity of this because I like to leave this in my fridge and have it over sort of 2 days. So I made quite a bit yesterday and I drank it all last night and today. So I'm going to do the same again. My sister also really loves it. So it's a great, great, great coffee drink. Because I'm making quite a large quantity, if you were making it just for one person, I would usually do 1 tablespoon coffee, 1 tablespoon sugar, 1 tablespoon water, and mix that together to go just on the top of one person's coffee. I mean, quite a large amount, but the simple ratio is one part, one part, one part. So it's instant coffee that you need. So I'm going to weigh out, this is a 1/2 cup. Add that, pop that out of the way, and we're going to add brown sugar, again personal preference. So there we go. Oh, I've made a mess yet again. What am I like? What am I like? And lastly, 1/4 cup or 1/2 cup even of hot water, and go ahead and pour that in. And I'm going to use one of my little straws. I'm going to be using this to drink later on. Give it a little stir. All the coffee and the sugar should dissolve. You'll see it's a very dark liquid, just like coffee usually is. We're going to completely transform this into something thick, luscious, airy. It's going to get a lot lighter in colour, a lot creamier in texture, just a lot toastier in general. So grab your hand whisk or manual whisk or stand mixer if you've got one, whatever is good, honestly. Pop them in, just like so. Make sure everything's working. Boom. So already, and I'm not even there yet, you can already see how light it is. See, it's completely changed, colour and texture. It's a lot fluffier. So we're nearly there already, just keep going. When you think you've got it, you probably still need to go a little bit longer. You want it to be the thickest peaks, that when you take out the sticks, or you take out your whisk, it stays like a mountain. So, as you can see now, you see those peaks, it's staying, flip upside down, it's not even going to fall out. What once was a little tiny volume of liquid at the bottom is now the huge, fluffy ball of deliciousness. As you can see, it's really light in colour, light in texture, consistency. It keeps that peak when it comes up, so it's whipped completely all the way through, aerated, light, fluffy and creamy. Fill it up, fill her up. You take some of your mixture, still got the whisks in, and lift up some of that. Look at that, that is like foam. It's delicious. Just pop that on the top and look at it floating. Look at that. Delicious. Whipped Delgona, the Delgona, whatever it is, coffee. Mix it in. And then let's have a little taste. You know what? I think you can use a little more. I'm gonna pop some more on the top of that. Delicious. Okay guys, so that brings us to the end of the video. I will insert a clip later on once the bread is baked, but I'm assuming you guys all know how that works. Let me just get the bake time for you. Once it's risen, which you can clearly see it has done, you're going to want to punch the dough back down, get some of the air out, divide it into two pieces, roll the pieces long enough to fill two well-oiled loaf pans and leave to rise again until the dough has reached the rim of the pan. Then bake, and this is the important part, 400 degrees Fahrenheit for 40 minutes. Rub hot bread with water and wrap in a tea towel to sweat, to soften the crust. Go ahead and get my Atlantic sea salt grinder and just grind that onto the top. Don't be afraid if it looks like it's too much, it's probably not. Some of it will melt into the fudge. If you've got it at the right consistency, you should be good. And then just go ahead and wrap that with a little more cling film. You want to leave the fudge to rest from anywhere from 4 hours to overnight. Obviously overnight will give you the best results, and 4 hours it will be set if you've left it in the fridge. You can also freeze this and use it as like a hot fudge sauce that you melt down for desserts in the future. So it's a really versatile, great tasting, delicious, simple recipe. And we've got our bread, and then we've got our awesome whipped coffee. So it's been amazing baking and cooking and whisking and mixing and chatting with you guys. Thank you so much. If you like this video, give it a like. If you don't like it, dislike it. Tell me why. We can beef, we can go for some. I'm ready, I've got these hands, bitch. Got these titties as well, okay? Anyway, so like, share, subscribe, comment, all of that good shit. If you do make any of these, please send me them and let me know that you've made them. Instagram is the Paris Grande. I'd love to see some pictures. And I will do my best to link the recipes below. If I do forget, just ask and I will send them over to you. Thanks, guys. First loaf, fresh out of the oven, still hot. And to know that it's ready, if you give it a knock, it should sound hollow. So I'm gonna leave that to rest just for like a few minutes, and then I'll get it out, put it on the cooling rack. And there we have the first loaf of bread. Putting the second one in now. I'll crop this, I'll edit this. I'll edit it, I will. I'm a fucking master editor. Fucking cock destroyer.